Well, as you're no doubt hearing the course of this video, it's a pretty wild day out there. About 60 mile an hour gusts and snow is on its way down. So I decided to stay at home, leave the Christmas shopping for another day, and I'm going to make a little socket to remove that fitting in there. This is the one that the float needle seats on. The fuel comes into the carburetor via that fitting. So yesterday was quite successful with the little tool for removing the jet which is in there. So we'll make something that will get this out without damaging it, hopefully. I'm just in the process of turning the OD of the bar down to 1¼ inches. It takes a little while with a bar this diameter. It's fairly hard steel. I've taken a very rough sketch of various measurements that I need. Next thing I'm going to do, because I've had the milling slide on this yesterday, I'm just going to put the top slide into true. Now you can do this with a test bar, and I've got one I could put between centres, but sometimes it's just as easy when you've got lots of rough cuts to make. You can take a few light ones and then measure at either end of the bar so that it's turning straight, and then just true up the top slide, because never assume that the zero mark is actually dead parallel. Sometimes it is, but it's worth checking. So I've just been setting up a little Mitutoyo adjustable mic, and you get these test bars with one of these, so you can zero it. You make the adjustment at this end. Not used this one, so nice to finally find a use for it. Be worth cleaning it up sometime, actually. So I've now turned the basis of the tool. You can see had to reduce the diameter quite a bit, and being a hard material, I've only just managed to, I think it was a maximum of 5/1000ths cut, so I could take before I lost the finish. So yeah, it's taken a little while, but that diameter there is now 1¼ inches, which is much more sensible. There's no need to have a massive diameter at the working end. So I'm doing a bit of a cheat here, setting this up between centres, and there are more accurate ways to do this, but I know that my tailstock and headstock are aligned, so I've put a dead centre in the spindle, and both ends of this workpiece are centre drilled, so I've just aligned them between centres and adjusted the milling slide to suit. Saves a lot of time. I'm just marking up the end of the bar. I can use the dials on the machine, but it's useful to have a visual reference as well. So that's that. We'll put that back on the lathe now. We've sorted that set up and mill, I think it's about 1/4 inch. So I've milled the slot in the tool now. 625 I wanted, so it's just slightly oversized. Just a thousandth oversized. And it's a beautiful fit on that brass fitting. Just drops on nicely. I think we definitely will want that aluminium spacer just to steady it up. But what I am going to do, I think, is bore a hole in the middle of that and use some of that quarter inch tool steel that I was using yesterday to make a little pin, which will just drop very slightly into that recess there. What it mustn't do is touch the seat at the bottom, because that's where the fuel needle seats. But if it would just sit, say, 1/8 of an inch down in there, that'd be perfect. So this is machined to give clearance for these little levers here. So with a bit of luck, it shouldn't damage those. But being a nice snug fit, it'll put all its load hopefully through the flats. So the next thing to do, actually, while I've got the milling slide on there, is to mill a flat, bore through on centre, and put a little Tommy bar on it. I should think something about 4 inches would be about right. So I've got a piece of tool steel there. The oh dear, that is, well, it measures up 12.65 millimetres. Although I normally work in thousandths of an inch, in this case this is a 12.66 reamer, so 0.2 of a millimetre clearance. That should be a very nice fit. So I've just put a clock in the collet chuck and I've centred it up across that way. So now we can just find the centre, which is there. I can then lock off that slide, mill a little spot on that, spot drill it, and then start drilling through. So I've now bored and reamed a quarter inch hole in the end of the tool. I've got some quarter inch tool steel. I'm just going to face the end to this diameter. This is a little hole gauge. So that'd be a nice snug fit in there, just a little bit of clearance. This hole here actually goes significantly deeper than the where the fitting bottoms out on the casting. So if I make the centre pin the same depth as this face here, and I know it's not actually going to touch the needle seat at the bottom. The little pin, so we'll just put a little drop of Loctite on it and see if we can press it in there. when a plan comes together. It's going to work quite nicely, I think. Didn't press in quite as far as I wanted, I think. What I've probably done is put slightly too much Loctite on it, and it's just collected at the bottom. But there is about 15-20 thousandths clearance, so yeah. It doesn't actually look like there's bearing on the top of the fixture. No brass on the radius, so I think we're alright. It bang in the middle, so I don't think we'll actually need any fixing. I was going to put a grub screw in the top, but I don't think I'll bother. So I think we can call that finished. I'll probably try it out, and if the fitting in the carburetor proves stubborn, or as I was intending to do, make a support ring for it. But that Tommy bar isn't going anywhere. Yeah, quite happy with how that's turned out. We'll just set it up and give it a go.
Hey. I think I'll just bring that out gently because of the rust. So I might have spent some hours making that, but I've got this irreplaceable fitting out with no damage whatsoever. So we'll just clean that up and be able to use it again. Whereas if I'd knackered that in the process of trying to get it out, goodness knows how many hours it'd take me to make one of those. Probably a lot longer than the tool, I should think. Then I'd have needed to make the tool to put it back in again. Yeah, hopefully you can now see why. Probably not in this light, but nah. Anyway, it's very rusty and horrible in there. So now we've got all the brass bits out, this can go in phosphoric acid, which will eat through all that rust overnight, and blocking up the jet and so on should be history. There we are. Hope the video has been of interest, and thank you very much for watching.